Hey guys, this is StuMurray47 here, back with another Superman-related review. And in today's review, we're going to be looking at the next Superman-related character in the DC Chess Collection. This is issue number 37, and it's New 52 Supergirl. Now, anyone that's been following Eaglemoss or the DC Chess Collection will probably know that I think it was last year, they actually started producing the DC Chess Collection. Now, this was a Batman-only collection. Of course, the black pieces, ironically, were all the Batman characters, be it Batman, Robin, Nightwing, Alfred, Commissioner Gordon. And, of course, the villains, Joker, Penguin, Two-Face, they were, of course, the white side of the set. And after it was done, and because it was so popular, they've decided to actually do another chess collection, this time depicting Justice League, or essentially Justice League heroes, Justice League villains, and essentially it's a new 52 chess collection. So the first set I actually got was issue number, I think it was 35, which was Superman. He came along with a question as a two-pack. So I collected Superman. My biggest negative with him was that his neck wasn't painted. He was the new 52 Superman, yet he didn't have the high collar as he should have. So I was planning on painting that. I've still not painted it. I've been really busy lately. However, this issue came out really recently in the UK and I had to pick it up. So as I said, this is Supergirl. Now, whenever you buy these in the UK and probably in the US as well, they actually come in a plastic bag. And of course with this, you'll of course get the magazine, which gives you information about the character, gives you images, and it also tells you about why she's been chosen as that particular piece. But of course you can see her here. Now, one thing you have to learn about Eaglemoss is these things are all hand-painted, and so the quality control is usually shocking. I must admit, if you had 10 of these in a store, 9 of them will have issues. So I only had a choice of 2, and this one was definitely the best. The other one had an eye on her cheek. She looked like Sloth from the Goonies. It was hilarious. So this was definitely the best one. I'm not sure what her S is going to be like, but we shall see. Now on the back, sorry for the noise, it shows the next issue, which I am definitely getting. And it's obviously issue number 38, and you've got Lex Luthor. Absolutely fantastic. I think he's the Black King in this set. What I love about it is you can see it's a truly brilliant piece of art. I love this piece of art. I forget who drew it, but it's very kind of Yul Brynner-esque. And I love that on his badge that it says Vote Lex, and the image looks identical to his look in the animated series, which I thought was a nice touch. And the figure, which looks brilliant, depicts him standing on his base with a big skull there. I think he's the Black King. He's got his foot up on the skull, holding a piece of kryptonite, and he's even got the Vote Lex badge as well. So, of course, this looks brilliant. However, we shall see what the final figure looks like, but you can see he's even got a kryptonite ring there. So, looking forward to that. What I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to go ahead and get Supergirl and the magazine out of packaging, and we'll take a bit of a closer look at it. Okay, so I've opened the packaging. I've left Supergirl in her box just now, if only because I wanted to show you the magazine that comes along with the set. As I said, DC Chess Collection, it's very cool. They often use a really striking piece of artwork for the cover, and this is no exception. I'm really, really a big fan of her S in this new incarnation, the way it's kind of angular, pointed. I must admit, even though I'm a huge Superman fan, I know a lot about the comics, a lot about the movies, everything. I am really, really far behind with New 52. I've been so busy with this channel and my work job, and we're moving home soon, and I just have not had a chance to read New 52. I've read a couple of issues of each story, so I understand I'm really far behind, but it's something I'm hopefully going to be trying to rectify soon. But just going into the book, of course, a lot of this I don't really know. I'm a bit hesitant to read it, to be honest, if only because I'm going to be reading it eventually. I'd rather not ruin it. But what's good is at the left here, it shows you the pieces that are revealed so far for the white piece of the board. Of course, you've got Aquaman, Supergirl, Martian Manhunter, Green Arrow, Green Lantern, Firestorm. You've got Wonder Woman, Hawkman, Superman, Zatanna, Flash, Booster Gold, Batman, of course. You've got Shazam or Captain Marvel, Cyborg, and Power Girl. So really, really cool. They've got a good variety of characters there. Of course, as you can probably see from Supergirl there, the symbol, I know it's a bit out of focus. Supergirl is actually a pawn, which I was quite surprised at. Now, I don't really play chess, but I didn't think Supergirl would be a pawn on the board. However, maybe more like a knight, maybe. But, I mean, it's got a really in-depth story about Supergirl. Of course, can I just say I love her new costume. These boots were an inspired design choice. I think Jim Lee designed them, as far as I'm aware, and I think they're a great choice. Of course, the way that the underwear's kind of into the bodysuit there is very, very cool, and the fact it's still armoured, love it. The wraparound cape, really looking forward to a DC collectible Supergirl figure. You know, obviously, Mattel will be good, but DC collectibles often really go above and beyond with the sculpt. Anyway, it goes into a lot of detail, telling you obviously about family reunion and her with Superboy. As I said, I'm going to hold off from reading this, but you do get a lot of information in the magazine. Obviously, it talks about Hit-El, which is cool. As I said, if there's any information you want for this magazine, I can certainly let you know in the comments section. But not only that, it then goes into a history of Supergirl and the awesome Crisis on Infinite Earths cover by Alex Ross. I love this image. It has so much detail. You could look at it for like an hour. There's so much information in there. But it talks about Brainiac and it essentially goes into a lot of detail of the history of the character. And then, of course, it talks about essentially all the characters that are close to her or people that she's come into contact with, you know. Just going on, of course, it shows you more images, but one of the interesting things here is it shows you an image of her expertly painted. Now, I'm guaranteeing mine won't look this good, but this is what she would look like had someone taken the time and care and attention. Usually, I can tell in the production line, they're just painting her as quick as possible and moving her on. So you often find that you do get a lot of quality control issues. I mean, bear in mind, you can paint them yourself. There's nothing to stop you if you're quite skilled. However, you know, I think when you're paying for it, you're wanting it to look good. One of the great pieces of image here, one of the great images, I should say, is this one here. A great shot of Supergirl who's punched Superman, and he just looks like he's in agony there. And finally, as I said, just a good shot of Wonder Woman with Supergirl wrapped up in the lasso of truth. And finally, as I said, here's an image of the next figure in the line. So anyway, that was the comic. I just thought, or comic, that was the magazine you get with it. I just thought I'd give you a quick preview there. But I highly recommend this collection. I know it's quite difficult to get in the US and it's quite expensive. I think it's about $16 in the US or thereabouts for these, for the magazine and the chess piece. In the UK, it's about £7.99 or £7.99. I actually got this one cheap. The store I got at, for some reason, it's literally just come out, but they had it in the clearance section, so of course I nabbed it. Very, very cool. Now, what I'm going to do is, very briefly, I'm going to get this out of packaging, but I'm just going to show you one nice touch. Of course, they're very secure in there. You know, they always make these so that they're sandwiched quite securely, but the cool part of it is, of course, it says DC Comics on the top. But the excellent thing is it has the We Can Be Heroes awesome wraparound on the back of the box. There's a little scratch there. But I mean, this would even make a good little display box. You know, you could always have this one here and have the next one sideways. It would be a really, really nice touch. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and get Supergirl out of packaging and we'll take a closer look and see just how good or bad she actually is. Okay, and here's Supergirl out of packaging. And I must admit, she is not the worst figurine I've ever got from Eaglemoss. Of course, that's not necessarily saying much. I have had some pretty shocking paint jobs in the past. Even the S on the Superman for this set was pretty bad. In fact, I've never seen a good one yet. And all the ones I've seen in the stores, they're pretty sloppily painted. The S on this figure is kind of similar. But as I said, it's not the worst one I've ever had. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give you a quick 360 of the figurine. Of course, she's depicted in her flying pose there, so it's just the tips of her toes that are touching down, which is a good touch. Of course, the paintwork seems to have gone up the base, though. You can see that part of her boot is actually coloured silver. That's a minor little thing, though. It's not a major issue. As I said, the major issue is kind of the S on the chest. But I do think it's a nice little sculpt, and for the size, I mean, this is pretty small. Here's my hand in comparison. So you're looking at about 3 inches tall, if you're lucky, including the base. And of course, she has a pawn. Now, the pawns in this chess set, of course, come on the smallest bases, whereas Superman was a king and he's on a, like Lex Luthor, on a base that's about 2 or 3 inches tall. So I'm just going to take her off the base here and give you a bit of a close-up. This is usually where these figurines start falling down, is when you close up on them and you can see the paint. But she's okay. I mean, you can see the S there's pretty sloppily done. From a distance, it looks okay, and I do have every single Eaglemoss Superman-related figure from the Eaglemoss DC Superheroes pack, as well as the chess pack. So this one will go quite well with the rest of them. Obviously, the face, I think, has come out probably the best out of everything. I mean, obviously, you can see there's kind of lines going away from the eyes. But once again, we're very close here. Actually, it looks pretty shocking up close, but from a distance, it looks okay. The sculpt work is usually brilliant on these figures. If I was to get a professional painter to repaint this, you can tell that they would do a really, really good job. The knees, well, pretty sloppy. And as I said, you know, it's one of these things, you've got to take what you get. These are mass-produced, and they are all individually hand-painted, so you've got to assume that they've got a quota to meet. You know, they might have to paint 50 figurines that hour or 30 an hour, so that they're going to go through it. But I mean, it's a really nice little figurine. As I said, you can see her toes there. She's got a little bit of a base under her foot to give her stability, which is totally fine with me. As I said, if you can ignore the paint, it's an okay little figurine. Now on the bottom, it always tells you the unique code, which is BEQ9385. And of course, the 2013 Supergirl. So okay, as I said, it's not going to win any beauty prizes, but just to give you a little comparison, I'm just going to get the book again, get her in focus, and I'm just going to do a quick comparison. So I'll just move the camera back slightly. So this is what the kind of advertiser is looking like. And you can see a vast difference, you know, everything. I mean, even this one doesn't appear to be amazingly painted, but look at the detail on the S and the detail on the face. And then what I'm just going to do is just bring in my one. So, yeah, I mean, it's okay. I mean, as I said, the one on the left, you can tell they got someone to spend a good 20 minutes on it alone. But, I mean, it's the exact same sculpt. You can see the cape on this one seems to be much more flush, whereas this one is raised up. I think you'll probably find that the head and the cape are a separate piece entirely. If I was to pull this off and break it, you would find that the head and cape would just remove. So as I said, you can see here, they've kind of rushed it. I mean, the top of the S here is pretty shocking. But glad to have it. I mean, as I said, oops, sorry guys. That was my camera, I swear. Anyway, this was just a quick review. As I said, it's the Eaglemoss DC Chess Collection. It's issue number 37, which is Supergirl. It will look good from a distance. I mean, just for argument's sake, I'm just going to move the camera quite far back, and she looks fine. She looks okay from that distance. I mean, it's like HeroClix figures. Anyone that collects HeroClix, I don't really collect them to play. I just collect them for my collection, as it were. And some of the painting on those is pretty shocking, but if you put them far enough away, they look just fine. So anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed the review. I'm sort of kept you so long on this little one. And if you've got any questions, comments, queries, anything at all, I'd love to hear from you. And hopefully I'll see you on the next review. So thanks for watching. This was Stu Murray 47. Thanks guys, bye.